Welcome back, and we are live, the only live wrestling program each and every week right here on TNT. And we have got another tremendous crowd on hand checking out the action where the big boys play. And hey, right off the bat, I want to say hello to a couple guys that have written and told us every week they have a Nitro party. That's right, everybody getting together on Monday night. And check it out, WCW Monday Nitro. Kenny McDade over there in North Carolina, Gary Wilkins in Pittsburgh. Hello, have a good time, stay out of trouble. Whatever you do, look at this dude.
Look at this, he's got Diamond Dallas's diamond rings on.
I bet he bought them cheap.
Well, I know Diamond Dallas had to pawn them, that's the rumor I get. So he must have gone to a pawn shop and picked them up.
This guy's still trying to pawn, talking about pawning, he's trying to pawn off these Disco Fever CDs to everybody. This guy is, he's living in his own little world.
Well, he's giving them away now, he just handed that one to the ref, to the ring announcer. And what a match made in heaven, boys. The man that instigated the Shake Your Booty Tour against the Booty Man. We'll see who's got the booty tonight.
The Booty Man, who defeated Diamond Dallas Page last night and took it all. And I mean took it all. The Booty Man, and the crowd really reacting here to the Booty Man. I tell you what, every week, this guy looking better and better and better. He is in excellent condition. He is all offense, and he is focused.
I'll tell you how dangerous this man is. Hogan sent him to the Dungeon of Doom as a spy. For 1 year, he lived like a rat. He did everything he had to do. He's nothing but a lying, cheating spy. He sabotaged Kevin Sullivan, all for Hulk Hogan.
Well, that's just what you would say, wouldn't you?
Well, that's exactly what happened. That's why he said that.
The Booty Man now giving us a look here at he's giving me a little bit more of a look of his rear end than I normally care to see, but there's no accounting for taste when it comes to Taylor's. At least not his ring attire is concerned.
I like that billboard, though. Monday Nitro Fever.
There you go. And Disco Fever now. This one with a bigger right hand. The Booty Man very quick. Take Disco right into the top turnbuckle.
Let me tell you, I'm like the Booty Man. We saw him the first night on Nitro when he appeared and just cleaned the house on the Dungeon of Doom and the Horseman, baby.
The Booty Man all over. Disco Fever now sends him up once, knocks him down again, and that'll slow you down in a bit. Oh, there she is! The Booty Babe.
The what?
The Booty Babe. She is out and she is looking
pretty good.
Babe?
Pretty good. Looks like she's got a feather duster. Well, Yoni Babe.
Gotta admit it, she's looking pretty good.
Boy, you aren't kidding. I'll tell you, the only babe I know is up for an Oscar, and it's a pig. Shame on
you. Oh, look at this. A little inspiration here. These two seem to speak the same language. Oh, easy. Big right hand, rubbing it for good luck and laying it on the booth. Oh, excuse me, laying it on Disco Fever. The Booty Man with an Irish whip.
Oh,
knee right on the chin. Put it on the button. Hooks the leg.
He got him.
A little bit of inspiration here from the Booty Babe. And I tell you what, when it comes to visual stimulation and ring support, the Booty Babe is about as good as it gets.
Oh, look at this.
Look at this.
Oh, and another lip lock by the Booty Babe. Oh,
That might be all he needs to get himself over the top, baby. Because I tell you one thing for sure.
Woo!
I've got a little darling named Deborah. If somebody tries to get in between us, he better bring his fat lunch.
Well, there's the Booty Man and the Booty Babe. She should get arrested for impersonating a lampshade.
The man who put Diamond Dallas Page out of the sport of wrestling walks off with the four.